Will, sponsored by CSJ, Natural Dog Food.
Saturday morning, before the working tests start, and the officials carefully walk through the cover for the briefing with the chief steward, Mark Whitehouse. It's important to make sure those throwing the dummies are throwing them in the right direction, and they're synchronised to follow the gunshot.
That's got to go over that fence. It's got to get towards that cover. It needs to be deeper. Pick it up, mate. Do it again or throw another.
The competition has two tricky built-in distractions for the ducks in the form of a rabbit and pigeons.
Send your dog.
Down, mark, retrieve. Then, as you send, judges will say, send your dog. As he sends his dog, he's not seen any of that rabbit. And once he goes over that fence, the distraction's from cover to cover. And if he does identify it and acknowledge it, leave that, pick that.
Straight for it.
The thing is, it ain't over difficult. The John's hit a good point there, is that banking does drop away. And his horizons are that, you know, you could lose him other side of that banking, but that becomes an handling issue, doesn't it?
Prior to a retrieve, just before the gunshot, pigeons are released up from the pile of brushings, causing the other distraction. The dog has to ignore these in favour of the dummy. This is a popular sport that always gathers swathes of spectators. 6-year-old Bryn Amber Max, handled by Di Pither. Judges give more points to a dog if it marks the drop dummy and then goes straight to the area where it landed, before the find and the retrieve. Max was working well away from the dummy before the find, so he was relying on Di's directional commands. Ideally, he'd be looking for a speedier search and find. This is David Williams with Rose of Egremont. She's just approaching 4 years old. Taking a bit of finding. Now for a retrieve in the opposite direction. It's a blind retrieve. The dummy is in a heap of brushings at the far end.
David Williams, this little female. Hardy's old butcher Ben was a fire. Canine also Swift was a female.
That was quite a long retrieve. David will be pleased with that.
Very well.
Moving on to the water, we've seen other dogs get totally sidetracked by the rabbit distraction. Let's see how Rose gets on. Well, that couldn't have been better. However, she failed to find the dummy in the water and came out. She went in again and, after quite a while, emerged with the quarry, nearly out of time. David was competing against England's Brian Wade with Shallowk West Ellie. Both dogs put on a great display of quartering. Di Gregory for Wales, with Dregoch Brook, 38 months old. She's marked the dummy. Spot on. A very good retrieve.
Dregoch Brook, David Gregory for Wales.
Now for the blind retrieve. Again, the dummy has been hidden under the brushings at the bottom. So close. So close. Didn't pick up any scent. Brooke went off left towards the tree and paused there for a little while before returning to the brushings and making the find.
And there's no doubt about it. You might be nervous. You might be a little bit kind of unsure at times. When you get in that arena, you're working with your dog. You're working for your team. You're working for your colleagues. And it is a great, great feeling.
Nearly dropped it. Onto the pigeon distraction. Into the brushings she goes, and out flies the pigeon. Brooke is in there, she must be able to see. The shot's been fired and the dummy thrown. She took the right line. Bang on. The water wasn't quite as good for David. Brooke was distracted by the rabbit and paused in thought, as most of them did. She then took to the water too far to the left and couldn't find the dummy. She did find it, but it took 30 seconds before she reappeared from the water. It seems a long time when you're waiting. Again, a really good display of quartering to flush out the game. Who's this lively little fellow? David, tell me about your dog.
Sid, his name is. He's an English Springer Spaniel. His kennel name is Edwardiana Howdy. I got him off a friend of mine called John Edwards. He's 2 years old, and he's a fantastic dog. I've had him out today. Luckily enough, just come second in the international test. So over the moon, pleased with him. He's great.
How did you find the course?
The course is fantastic. Mark Whitehouse has put on a terrific course, caught everybody out. It's been brilliant. Brilliant, and the cover. The cover's been absolutely great too. Because some of these tests, I mean, there's hardly anything on the ground, and these Spaniards love to hunt the cover.
What about the tricky little rabbit?
Yeah, well, that was tricky, and it caught quite a few people out too. Luckily, we got away with it. He didn't quite go in the water as I'd liked, but a couple of pips on the whistle, and he went back in. So it was tough, tough.
What about the pigeons?
Well, the pigeons are great. They add so much to it, you know. There's a bit, especially halfway through the course. I mean, the dogs, they get the scent of it, and they thrive on that, and they think there's more pigeons to come, you know, so it gets them hunting hard, you know.
He's only 2 years old, so he's got a lot of life in front of him.
He has, yeah. Yeah, got high hopes for him. I'm quite new to the game myself, so hopefully we'll do something with him. You know, he's definitely got the capabilities. It's just whether I can steer him to the awards, you know.
What's his temperament like?
Oh, he's got a lovely temperament. Fantastic. You know, he's a joy to be around. He just wants to play.
You're not feeding him high energy food, obviously.
No. Feed him CSJ. Champ. It's great for him. Works great. If I fed him some of the other ranges, the high loss and things like that, it would send him over the edge. But I've got a bitch, and she's on the high loss, and that's great food for her. It compliments are great.
He's enjoyed himself today, and so have many others, including field trial champion, Shallow Quest Stag. No time wasted there. I managed to catch up with a Welsh Spaniel team. How's the Welsh team enjoying the competition?
Very well, thank you. I think the dogs, well, I would all three, four, all of the dogs have gone really, really well so far. I'd like to thank our sponsorship, Kerry, which has sponsored over the years. We're really, really grateful for the sponsorship. As a team, we've trained together. I think it's shown this year more than any year. I would just like to say my run personally had a bit of bad luck. but the ground is brilliant. Absolutely fantastic. Good fences, good brushings all around for the dogs to go under. They've all put their nose down. Obviously, because there's no game about, they've been, a couple have been running with heads up, thinking, where's the birds? Because obviously we do a bit of trailing as well.
And I think that's particularly where I struggle. She was not getting her nose down and hunting as well as the other boys.
Same as me.
And, you know, that was sort of my downfall. And I think for me, it was just nerves more than anything else. I got the better of me. I was blowing the whistle a bit too early and, you know, she was stopping herself. But, you know, that's how it goes.
I think from a point of view of the course, it's really natural. Yeah. It's fantastic what they've done, you know, which tested the dogs and the handlers. Yeah. Like we've got Die, well, they're all Dies, okay? Die, three, and die, is confusing sometimes. But the main thing is, like, the middle Die is a very experienced handler. But the two boys, well, his first time and his second time, they've done Wales really proud today, boys. You've really, really done well today.
Thank you. And have you done much training at home?
Yeah, lots of training, lots of training. You've got to do months in advance. You know, yeah.
Preparation for this.
Yeah, I mean, if we didn't train hard, we wouldn't get selected. Alan puts us through a rigorous test. And
it's lovely.
I suppose at home you've all got different terrains to work on, haven't you?
Yeah, and I think that's the advantage of us getting together as well. Then we're training on the same stuff and we've got options of where we train. And, you know, trying to replicate as close you can to the actual course. But, for me, the sort of last 2 weeks has been a bigger build-up with the training. It's big anyway. You want to do well, so you put the training
in. Whatever training you do.
It's a lot of pressure out here. Like, you know, you've got all these people and everything going on around you, and they're only dogs after all.
Of course, they're not robots.
And, you know, the main thing, I've got to say, like, it's been a great start this morning, guys. Well done.
And in reflection, the dog went well. It was me that maybe needed a bit more calming down. But
well.
overall, myself.
Moving on to the Labrador Retrievers and is Alan Rees, with 7-year-old field trial champion Jobes Hill Ragnar of Flypatch. It's a long way, but he found it. This is a dog with plenty of experience and a good nose. Bit of question going on between the officials and Graham Jones, chief steward, in the middle. Solved. This is 3-year-old Stikesboy Chlan Gnidr, handled by Hayden Wilmot. In this edited clip, he hunts back and forth in that area before disappearing out of sight and down into the water, where the dummy was found. The whole retrieve from the handler and back to him took 1 minute and 5 seconds. Slipside Danzy Jones, 6 years old, handled by Nigel Probert. Now this dog can cover some ground. This isn't quite the full length of the course. He's got to swim the pond and the dummy is just in front of the oak tree. That was impressive. For this one, the dummy is in the shadows of the trees on the middle right somewhere. Come on, where are you? How can 30 seconds feel like a long time? It does when you're waiting for your dog. It does when you're filming it. This dog is no fool. Why swim if I can run the short distance around? Now for the long one. The full length of the course. He's got to swim the pond. Takes a little time. But Slipside Danzy Jones is a strong, athletic dog. That jump must have been 20 feet. It's under the oak tree.
And now pushing her left hand towards that tree. And just push.
I think Nigel would be proud of that. It was a pleasure to watch, and a nice one to finish with. Look at him go. The presentations were awarded to the teams and winners by the Earl of Harewood, the Right Honourable David Lascelles. In the Spaniels, the winning team was England, receiving the Wilson Challenge Shield, captained by Ian Openshaw. The best Spaniel for three consecutive years went to Sean Moriarty from Ireland, with Tearsall Flash. The second place Spaniel went to David Williams with Edwardiana Howdy from Wales. Third place went to Brian Wade for England with field trial champion Shallow Oak West Phantom. Brian also took the prize for the highest individual number of points scored. 58 out of 60. Incredible. In the retrievers, it was England again taking the honours, captained by David Latham. The best retriever award went to John Halstead with Brocklebank Navigator of Chatsworth. Second retriever went to Saxophone Brown Ale of Linkswood, owned by Richard King. The third retriever was international field trial champion Bailey's Agazanis of Fenderwood. The best marking retriever cup went to Sean Diamond from Ireland with Duhuma Lad. The Shooting Times trophy and prize of £200 with rosettes and memorabilia to each of the team was won by England. Second prize for the whole team combined went to Ireland. Wales came third overall, second in the retrievers and third in the Spaniels. In fourth place came the Scottish team, captained by Joe McClure. The one with the most prestigious win was Sean Moriarty, in the limelight again, top dog of the CLA Game Fair 2015, the champion Tearsall Flash, more trophies than he could handle, best champion, best spaniel, best Irish dog, even the star had to lend support to his master.